Hello everyone, my name is Neo Mystic. I hope you guys enjoyed my tutorial yesterday. And this is what it looks like when it's finished. Now I placed a ground plane because, as you can see, my model goes a little bit lower. So this is the 000 point. Let's say you are building on a slope, and I know that Jesse will show you guys that you can have it until a certain type of slope. Basically, if you have a slope that goes like this, you will still see everything. You will see this little walk-up thingy. And what I'm going to do in the model itself, you can see I made a different line. I'm going to make these all vertical lines and this one horizontal ones, horizontal planks. Okay, so we did that. Let's get started with the unwrapping. I'm going to delete this one. I'm going to drag out a second screen, UV editor. Now, guys, be warned, this is not how you should do all your unwrappings. This is just how I do it, because this is easier for the type of model that I made. So be warned. First of all, I'm going to take all the beams. You know what? No, I'm first going to give everything a color, a texture. So, one, two, do I need three? I'll probably need three. So, just let's just add in a third one. I'm going to make this one the house planks. I'm going to make this one house beams, and the third one, I don't know yet, maybe roof. We'll see about that later. For these as well, I'm going to try to make planks that go from the top to the bottom. Now, look at this. These are all just cubes that I used, so that's going to be, well, easy to do with the way that I'm going to do it. There's no dragging and dropping and blah 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 with it. It's all just, well, one go. So I'm going to select everything, house planks, assign, just to make sure that I have a texture on all of these things. Then I'm going to select the beams, all of them. And as you can see, there's a lot. L, 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 L. L, L. Yeah, with the L key, you can just hover over a point and select it. I think I showed you guys that in the previous video as well. Okay, so these are going to be the house beams. Now, as you can see, nothing visually changed, so house planks, I'm going to make these more of a brownish type. Brown, yellowish, something like that. And these beams, I'm going to make a darker color. So darker brown, not too dark, like so. So we at least see a visual difference. My third one I'm going to use for door slash window. I hope I can do slashes. Okay, door slash window. So I'm going to select the faces for my doors and windows. Also on the inside, very important. And I'm going to assign these as well. There, so everything is assigned. These ones are just going to be, like I said, wood, and that's going to be a little bit of rotating and stuff, but we'll see what, you guys will see what I mean when we get to that. So now if I select everything and I do U, unwrap, you can see it looks really, really messy, just because I didn't put any UV and markings. I didn't mark any seams on multiple of these objects, so this looks very, very messy. Now, meaning I'm going to do everything in pieces, so first these, which I didn't have to unselect, but I'm an idiot. So yeah, you can see they're all going all over the place. The rotation isn't the same anywhere, so we'll have to adjust that as well. Okay, so I selected those, you, unwrap, and now you can still see that some of these are not unwrapped. Well, their rotation isn't right. So I'm going to select those, rotate, I'm going to hold down control, which doesn't work, so I'm unholding control, and I'm going to drag them to a good rotation, good position. There we go. I need to let my cat go outside or he's going to be annoying. And now that little annoying beast doesn't want to go outside. He's really annoying. Hold on. Okay, so we unwrapped all of those. Again, most of these rotations aren't right. I'm going to select all of these, grab, and I'm going to put them out here. Now the next thing, I'm going to take all these walls, all the walls that I want to have in the same texture, I'm going to grab, which are these. I'm sorry for the cat. Sometimes I wish I could kick him, but yeah, that's animal cruelty. And because of the cat, I did it wrong. So I'm going to take all the front faces, or maybe I should select the roof first and press H. That will, yeah, that will make it a lot easier. So I'm going to take all these faces, the front ones, these ones. There, all these, and this one, and on the back side, these as well. Now I'm going to go to front view, and I'm going to press U, unwrap from view, which is down here, so unwrap from view. Now you can see, I don't know what this is, and I don't know why I selected it, but it's probably something important, so I'll leave it. And that's going to be the unwrapping for the house, for the walls. You can see they're nicely covering each other. I need to do the same for these guys. There we go. View, project from view, select all of these, and I'm going to grab them there. So now, as you can see, everything is starting to look a little bit better. A little bit more organized. My cat is being really annoying. Stoppies! I'm sorry. So now these ones as well. Now I'm just going to normal unwrap these. And I'm going to put them, oops, not that one. And I'm just going to put them on top of each other. So you unwrap, L, I'm going to grab this one down, like so, there we go, I'm going to select all of these, grab on the Y axis, and I'm going to grab it down. Okay, so that's that part. Now the bottom part I actually wanted to put on the same layer as that, well, in the same group as that one, so I'm going to select these as well, like so, and now I'm going to do U unwrap. Now as you can see, everything is nicely with each other. So I'm going to grab this one down, L, grab this one down, there we go. Select everything and grab on the Y axis and grab it down. Okay, so we did that, we are almost through the door and the window. I'm going to do the same thing for this one. I'm going to do U, unwrap from view. So everything is on the same layer. L, wrap on the x-axis. There we go. And the door, L, grab, maybe box select, grab on the x-axis, and I'm going to put them on top of each other. Now all of these, I'm going to put it right there. And now in the unwrap, you can see we're getting closer and closer. I don't know, these are probably the stairs that are messed up everywhere, which is not a big deal. Next thing would be Alt H, so I can do the roof. And I'm just going to select the visible sides and go to top view, view, project from view, and now you can see the roof. I'm going to drag this one here. And the last piece is going to be the stairs. The bottom side, I can actually X delete this face because you'll never see that face. Same with this, no, not that one. This face, because you'll never ever see that. I can do that to other faces as well, but I'm too lazy to do that now. So I'm going to select all these side faces, all of these, tree, view, project from view. Select all, and I know this is a very tedious tedious way to work. I'm very much aware of that. View, project from view, and I'm going to try to put everything in the same location. View, project from view, and grab. Okay, so we unwrapped everything. At least I thought we did. Ah, right, I placed my inside, well, these walls in the middle of the project. So I'll need to take them out soon. Okay, I'm just going to do L, grab this way, L, grab, and they should fit nicely on top of each other. L, grab, L, grab. There. Now we still have a little bit of junk in here. So everything that's left in here, I'm going to box select. And come on, box select. And I'm going to scale that down. We're never, at least I'm never going to see those, I guess. So I'm just going to scale them down and I'm going to grab them. I'm going to grab them all the way up here into the corner. Okay, so now we need to fit in everything. The things that are bigger, you want to have more room for those. The things that are smaller, you do need room for those. for example, these front walls and stuff, you do need to have a little bit more room for those. So I'm going to start with taking these, putting them in a good spot. I'm going to try to not touch the edges. There we go. And for these beams, all of these beams, we don't need to have so much room for them. I'm going to drag open this screen so we can see that better. All of these, we don't need to have that much room for them. So I'm just going to select them all. Kind of put them on top of each other. There we go. There we go. And these as well. So I'll do a quick time lapse where I put all these parts into smaller locations so that will be easier. And I'm also going to throw out my cat because he's really annoying at the moment. So I'll see you guys when the time lapse is done.
calle, lo digo ya.
Mi alma fue Ruco, Lanzai, J Balvin, la familia, Sky, Mosty. Y está amaneciendo, el sol saliendo, y amanezco al lado tuyo, bebé.
Y aún no recuerdo lo que sucedió ayer. Quisiera saber cuál es tu nombre, mujer.
Pero qué placer, rumba, pa, 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 la que yo cogí anoche. Que yo cogí anoche, que no recuerdo lo que sucedió.
Pero qué horas son, qué fue lo que pasó, porque Faru tiene el carro parqueado en la habitación. Yo no recuerdo, solo sé que amaneció y que tenía un tatuaje que decía písenlo. Pero qué confusión, creo que cometí un error y mezclé los tragos y las pastillitas de color. Qué sentimiento, creo que tenía un medicamento. Eso que te noquean duro contra el pavimento.
Y son las 6 de la mañana y todavía no recuerdo nada. Ni siquiera conozco tu cara, pero amaneciste aquí en mi cama. Y son las 6 de la mañana y...
There, so that was a pretty fast time lapse. A very short one as well. Now, while I was doing that, I was thinking about something. What I was thinking about was, before we put all of these inside the map, let's first see if we get the rotation right. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go to my materials tab, out of edit mode, shift D. I'm going to duplicate a couple of these lights so I can see all around the building, and I should be in texture tab. Okay, so these ones, I'm going to drag them out just a tiny bit more, so I can at least see what's going on. Okay, so we've got this. What do we want to see? Well, that's very simple. We want to see the texture on top of our model. So the house planks, I'm going to go to my texture tab. I'm going to change it to image or movie, open, and in my textures folder, I have that texture because I found it earlier. It's the same one that I used for the other model, and you can see that nothing is popping up. Nope, still nothing popping up. Let's go to our materials tab, and now you can see that our planks are on top of our building. Okay, let's do the same for the house beams. New, image or movie, open, and this is going to be the same kind of texture. Same kind. I'm just going to use tree bark. Now, as you can see, this looks very, very messy and it's way too big. So I'm going to put this at 10, X and Y 10. This will make it a lot smaller, and we can already see that these beams are not in the right rotation. These ones are not. You can see it everywhere, the seams are going up, 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 instead of from the over the length like they are going here. So we'll need to change that. Don't worry, we'll get to that point. Let's first change the texture on our house planks as well. Maybe 10 by 10. Yeah, 10 by 10 is maybe a little bit too big, so 8 by 8. There, I think that's fine. And for this one, the rotation is fine, but you can see that the planks down here, that the rotation is not fine yet. Also, the scale is not fine. And keep in mind, if I select these L and I change this, which one am I holding? And I change the scale, the planks will become bigger or smaller. So you can adjust that manually as well. Okay, so let's start cleaning up this model, getting in the right rotation. These ones are not having the right rotation, so Those are the first one that I'm going to change. Rotate 90. And now you can see they do have the right rotation, but it's way too big. So I need to scale this up. And that's going to give me a problem, as you guys can see. Because if I put it now in my object, it's going to have the wrong, it's going to be outside of the map. So the biggest size that I can go for is this, meaning that here I need to put this at 10 by 10. I think that's good enough. For these top sides as well, the rotation is wrong. So I'll need to change that as well. Both outside as inside, so it's these guys. Rotate 90, and I'm going to drop them just on top of these other planks. There we go. So now when you look from afar, you can see a clear difference between the two textures. Okay, now the insides, because the other sides are so big, I want to get the these ones to be bigger as well. And I forgot to take a map. Yes, the sides, okay. So I'm going to box select, scale 0.8, let's say. Yeah, that should be fine. Scale 0.8 again. There. So now we have kind of big planks all over the place. And I can take these ones and drop them on top of these ones. It's not a problem if the height is not the same, because I mean you've got beams in the middle, which will take away, which will make sure you don't really see that they're not the same height. What you could do is just grab on the Y if you really want to have it the same height, just grab it on the Y and put it on the same height. What I don't like is that they all look the same, so grab Y, I'm going to put them the same height, kinda, like so, but that there's a difference between the textures. Okay, good. So our wooden shack is coming along, and I'm happy for that. Our beams are not fine yet, and our stairs, they're definitely not fine. I want all of these to be in a different rotation. Grab, rotate 90, grab everything, take this, I'm going to drag it in, whoops, I took too much. Take all of these, I'm going to grab them in, and I'm going to scale them down. So it looks like one plank, and I also need to put it into a right location for that. So basically one plank is going to be, grab Y, there, that seems about right. So basically you got a plank that goes up, and then we're going to get one plank that goes, that will fit in this spot and this spot and blah blah blah. So I'm going to take these, wherever they may be, there, okay. I'm going to scale them down as well, something like that. And if I put them up, you can see they kind of represent one plank. Of course, now I can start tweaking with those and put them in the right position and stuff like that. But first, let's put them in here, the right height. Something like that. So now I can see this plank. It has a little bit of a gap. Grab Y. Let's make sure that all these planks are just one plank. There, and this one. Grab Y. This is actually perfect, because on the inside of the door there's another plank, so this is just fine. Hold on. Okay, so now these ones, the last ones, and I'm going to make those into one planks as well, just to keep everything nicely together. And I know this is a huge job to do, and it's very tedious work, but this will make your model look twice as good as it would normally look. There, and again, grab Y, grab Y. Grab Y. And this gives the impression of having legit planks. What I could do is I could put it somewhere over here, then it looks like there's definitely a plank you can walk on. Okay, so as you can see, it starts to look like something decent, but we still have our wood problem here, our beams. So I'm going to take all the beams that have the wrong rotation, which are basically the beams that are horizontal. This one as well, this one, these two, and I think that's about it. Okay, that's all the planks that are in the wrong rotation. So I'm going to take all of these, rotate them by 90, and I'm going to put them here. Now I know what one of these things is. It's part of the planks. Yep, it's a little piece that's part of the planks. Anything else? No? Okay. So now you can see all the beams are in the right rotation. It's just these wooden planks that are still being a little bit annoying, but that's easily fixed. What I am going to do is, just because I'm lazy and I don't feel like doing that, I'm just going to grab this one. Oops. L. Grab this one, and I'm going to put it like so. I'm also going to take this wood, because I can see it, and I don't want to see it, come on. And I'm going to drag that in, so it's gone. Okay, good. Maybe I should drag it in a little bit deeper, like so. L. So I can drag in this one for one as well, so it looks a little bit better. Okay. So you guys see that I lost my view of the material. There we go, material is back. Now the roof. That's all the pieces that are over there. So B, rotate 90. I do want to have a very big planked wood roof, so something like this. Maybe that's a little bit too big. More like that then. Yes, that should be fine for the roof. I'm going to drag this one in as well. Like so. I'm going to take all the wood and I'm going to clean it up a little bit more. So B, grab, because they're all using the same texture. You don't need to go and make them all into a separate layer, because I mean there's so much detail into this wood you won't even notice it. Okay, so I think everything is done except for the doors and the windows. Come on. And I still need to drag these ones in as well. So wood. And these are going to be doors and windows. There we go. Now for the doors and the windows, why do I put them into a separate spot? I'm going to play around with the texture in this one. I'm going to color it just a tiny bit, make it look darker. So door window, let's make this into a yellowish. Let's see. Yep, those are those. And for the texture, I'm going to use the same wood texture that we used here. But again, you can see that the rotation is wrong. So 90, 5 by 5, maybe 8 by 8. There. So that's done as well. Everything is inside our unwrapping map, and we still have a lot of room free. So basically what we could do is we could take the big pieces like these ones. I'm going to Let's put this one out of the way first. This is the roof. Grab Y. Put the roof there. Put these ones right here. Oops. These ones here, and I'm going to scale them up. There we go. And these ones I can't scale now. So I need to reorganize a little bit more, or scale these ones down again and scale these ones up first, like so. There, and I can put my door in here as well. There we go. So that's done. Everything is scaled, everything still looks nice. The doors, of course, they look a little bit too bright, but that's going to change in a second. So the wooden planks, as you can see right here, they kind of look really good because they go down as well. Okay, so our little wooden hut is finished. Yay! Now in the next video, because I'm in 30 minutes, in the next video we're going to make the UV maps, the mapping. And we're going to import that into the Unreal Engine. It's the same basic principle as loading it into Unity, but I'm going to use the Unreal Engine because I like the way they use the textures more. So I'll see you guys in that video. Bye everyone.